What?
Deer. Dead deer.
Dead deer? Why?
People hunt them to eat for food.
Do deer eat people?
No.
Do people eat people?
No, of course not. What do you think we are?
I think you are a very primitive species.
What are you, soft-hearted? Cry when you saw Bambi?
Define Bambi.
Huh?
He doesn't understand. He's not from around here.
Oh, you don't speak any English, huh?
Our next movie is named Starman, and it begins in 1977 when America launched that Voyager spacecraft with its message to whoever might be living beyond the solar system. Remember that, you know, if you get this message, please give us a ring. And according to the movie, the message was received, and as the film opens, a visiting spacecraft crash lands in Wisconsin trying to respond to our invitation in Voyager.
That's where I'd go.
Is it Wisconsin? Well, they're actually aiming someplace else, but the plans go awry, and then the visitor, which is so far just a glowing ball of pure energy, floats into the house of a young widow, played by Karen Allen, and he sees a photograph of her late husband and turns into an identical clone of the husband. He then forces her to drive him to the great meteor crater in Arizona, where he has a rendezvous with his mothership that's going to pick him up again. And in this scene, they're on the road, and the Starman, played by Jeff Bridges, is gradually learning the ways of man.
Do you ever get hungry? Empty here, like a car needs gas?
Yes. This body has a terrible emptiness. This is called hungry?
Yeah, and when people get hungry, they have to eat food.
Eat? Yes, we must do that. We will stop at food station. You have hungry too.
I'm starving. I haven't eaten since.
Oh my God! Look out! What are you doing?
Okay?
Okay! Are you crazy? You almost got us killed! You said you watched me. You said you knew the rules.
I do know the rules.
Oh, well, for your information, pal, that was a yellow light back there.
I watched you very carefully. Red light, stop. Green light, go. Yellow light, go. Very fast.
That's an interesting otherworldly aura that Jeff Bridges brings to the Starman. They run out of money, but the Starman thinks he can take care of that in Las Vegas.
Where's my wallet? My wallet.
What is wrong?
Where the hell is my wallet?
What are we going to do now?
It's all right.
No, you don't understand. No credit card, no money, no car. No car. We're never going to get there on time.
It's all right.
Now.
Handy little talent you got there, but you better spread it around a little. These guys get kind of curious if you hit too many jackpots at once.
One of the nice things about Jeff Bridges' performance in this movie is that little bird-like kind of way that he has. He's a very intelligent creature from someplace else, but he's still learning how to use this human body. The movie has a lot of scenes like those two we just saw, where the Starman has those special powers, but nevertheless, he's sometimes totally mystified by human customs like red lights and green lights. And inevitably, the Starman and the human woman begin to respect each other and even to love each other on this road trip. The movie begins as science fiction, but it turns into a contemporary version of a road movie like It Happened One Night or They Live By Night or maybe even Badlands. It's very effective. Starman is a movie with interesting ideas and with a very sound and evolving emotional center, and I liked it a lot.
I think I liked it maybe even more than you did. Yeah. I think it's one of the highlights of the Christmas movie season, mm-hmm. which has had mostly disappointments for me. This is one I recommend flat out. No qualifications whatsoever. I liked everything about the film. Jeff Bridges has one of the best track records of mm-hmm. any actor working today for picking good movies. You look at his film, he's rarely in a bad film. Mm-hmm. And he does a terrific job here. Karen Allen is an exciting young actress. She finally gets a role worthwhile. We can put until September.
Isn't this
aside.
Interesting? The Starman makes a better romantic couple with Karen Allen than that guy.
The overtly romantic film. That's exactly right.
And I think it's a better love story than the one
set in Paris. Much better love story. And I think that's what really carries it,
uh-huh.
is that, you know, we can get carried away with technology with these science fiction mm-hmm. films if at the center is a human relationship, mm-hmm. a little bit of unrequited love here, as it's mm-hmm. going to turn out. It's wonderful, and we'll accept anything if that relationship is
And yet
key.
At the same time, also, there is a certain amount of science fiction here. For example, in the character by Charlie Martin Smith, it was the government scientist who was trying to chase this man.
Yes.
And was thinking, this is our big chance. This is a visitor from outer space.
Right.
And needless to say, in old science fiction tradition, the government is going to track him down and treat
right.
him like enemies and
right.
be very paranoid. So it's a lot of fun, this movie.
A lot of fun and a very wonderful
relationship. One of John Carpenter's best films?
The best, I think, since Halloween.